In this video, I'm going to be completing this table, finding these sums, their mean, the sample variance, and the sample standard deviation here in Excel. To find the sum of x, I'm going to click at the end of the data here and then press Alt equals, and Excel will automatically select the entire data. And then Enter will give me the sum of the values. To find the sample mean, I'm going to click here, press equals. I can do equals average, or I can just take the total here and divide by the number of observations, which is 6. And that gives -3 for the sample mean. For the deviation from the mean, denoted x minus x bar, that is the distance from the mean. I'm going to type equal 4 minus the mean, which is -3. So I can type -3 here and enter. And 4 minus -3 gives 7. So I'm going to click on the handle here and drag all the way down. To find the sum, again, I'm going to press Alt equals in Excel and enter, and that will give a sum of 0. The sum of deviations will always be 0 because the positive distances from the means will always cancel out the negative ones. That is, the total distances above the mean must equal total distances below the mean. Now for the squared deviations, I'm going to type equals. I'm going to take the first deviation here and square it. Enter. I'm going to grab the handle here and drag all the way down. And for the sum, I can grab this 0 because it contains the sum formula and just drag it to the right here. And that will give me the sum of the squared deviations. For the sample variance, I can use the built-in variance function in Excel, or I can just divide the sum of squared deviations by n minus 1. N minus 1 is 5, so that gives us 56. For the sample standard deviation, I can use the built-in function, or I can just take the square root of the sample variance, and that gives 7.48. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.